We've always prided ourselves in trying to be innovative. Nationwide, people have recognized us as being some of the leaders in certain areas of the field, including living donor liver transplantation, developing a transplant institute, the whole robotic kidney transplant part of it. We are definitely one of the innovators, and people look to us for guidance. Interestingly enough, the operation has not changed at all from 1970 till now. It was a good operation, it's done well for a long period of time. Like many things, we can do things better. And one of the first steps we've gone towards is trying to do this in a minimally invasive fashion. The ability from a surgical point of view to do the operation easier is much better. We where normally have 2.5 or 3.5 magnification when we do an open case. With a robot, we can go as close as 10.5 times strength and magnification to do the anastomoses. Everything's much more precise. And then we have a surgeon at the console, which is sort of like outside of the actual operating room table, but allows us to do the operation through pretty much 3D type glasses, and you're seeing everything at a much larger scale than you normally would laparoscopically. Any person who gets a kidney transplant, even if you're the skinniest person or the heaviest person, your minimum incision size is at least 1 foot long. And with a robotic kidney transplant, we just need enough of a hole in order to put the kidney in, which is about 2 inches in size. So the largest incision during a robotic kidney transplant is 2 inches, which obviously, if you think about it, will have generally less pain and less complications from the wounds that we have. And also with the robot and the technology we have with that, we can definitely change the fine nature of our movements. So our movements are much finer robotically than they are in real life. We've done more than 150, 160 robotic kidney transplants. Our operative times are exactly the same as an open kidney transplant. The length of stay is probably shorter by about a half day. The pain scores have been lower, and your incision is only about 2.5 inches long. So we're in a position that the wound infections are never really a big problem from that point. I've been kind of the Pied Piper for the robotic kidney transplant throughout the country. So whether it be at Duke, Mayo, Leahy Clinic, the robot's the same everywhere. So when we go ahead and train people at other institutions, they have the same equipment. With a robotic kidney transplant, you can mimic it with computer simulations and do the whole operation, at least on digital platforms initially. Then you can practice on organs that are not being used and then go on to the patients.
Right now, the operation is very standardized and we don't think twice about doing it for any patient at all.